This is a mini lesson on solving problems using Newton's laws. In particular, we're going to talk about a problem solving strategy involving free body diagrams, or also called force diagrams. The best way to talk about that is just to work some examples. So we're going to jump right in to working examples. Let's start with the example of a cart. Okay. And let's say that this cart is being pulled on by two horses. One is pulling with a force of 100 newtons at a 30 degree angle, and the other is pulling with a force of 50 newtons at a 60 degree angle. And let's give the cart a mass of, say, 30 kilograms, which is, 70 pounds or so, give or take. And also, let's say that this cart has wheels so that the friction is negligible, and you know the only forces in the horizontal direction on this cart would be from the two horses. Okay, well, whenever you have a situation like this where you have more than one force acting on an object, and you want to find something related to the force or the acceleration, by the way, I guess I should specify what we're trying to do here. We're trying to find the acceleration of the cart, and since acceleration is a vector, that means both magnitude and direction. So anytime you have a situation where there's more than one force acting on an object and you want to find something related to the force or the acceleration, the strategy to use is Newton's second law with free body diagrams. There's a series of steps laid out in your textbook, and I will find that so you can refer to the page number if you like. Okay, it's going to be in Chapter 4, and let's see, the problem-solving strategy that I'm referring to is on page 99 of the textbook. It's in section 4.5. And it's labeled problem-solving strategy for Newton's second law. So I'll be using that problem-solving strategy, and we'll be using this problem-solving strategy over and over for many different kinds of problems. And this is also the same type of problem that you will have on the second exam as the final problem. It will be a problem that uses this strategy. So it's one that you want to practice quite frequently doing the homework before the second exam. All right, well, with that out of the way, the first step is to read the problem, or in this case, listen to the problem statement, which I have already done for you, okay, and draw a picture of the system. We did that already, too. The second one is we want to label each force in the picture. You can label it with a number like 100 newtons and 50 newtons, or you can give it another name like, say, F1, which would be the force due to the first donkey, and F2, which could be the force due to the second donkey, for example. Step 4 is draw a free body diagram on the object. A free body diagram is when you draw something, usually just a circle or a square, that represents the object, and then you indicate all of the different forces that are acting on that object. It's conventional to draw them acting at the center of the object, even though in my drawing where I sketch the situation, the two horses are pulling on the front. For the purposes of the free body diagram, it's conventional, although not necessary, to draw the forces originating from the center. So I'm going to do it that way. Okay. We have F1 this way. Again, at a 30 degree angle. And we have F2 this way at a 60 degree angle. Okay. So we have finished step 4. Well, it says choose a coordinate system. I suppose technically that's part of step 4, so we'll do that. We'll choose a coordinate system where X is forward and Y is off to the side according to that cart. Okay, so we're done with step 4. Step 5 is to apply Newton's second law. And I actually like to break step 5 up into two parts, say 5A and 5B. Okay, so let's say, and I'm going to erase the picture right now, just so I don't run out of room a little bit later. Label F1 is 100 and F2 is 50. Mass of the cart is 30 kilograms. That's all the information that I just erased that we're going to need later. Okay, so let's break step 5 up into two parts. Okay, let's call 5A. Resolve the forces into their X and Y components. In this particular case, that means that I need the X and Y components of F1, which would look like this. That's F1X. And that's F1Y. And I also need the X and Y components of F2. This would be F2X. And this is F2Y. So that's what you do first. That's step 5A. Resolve all of the forces that are in your free body diagram into X and Y components. Okay, F1X is going to be F1 times a trig function of 30 degrees. Which trig function? Well, F1x, the vertical or the horizontal red arrow, is adjacent to the 30 degree angle. That means I should use cosine. Since F1 is 100, and cosine of 30 is 0.87. F1x is therefore 87 newtons. F1y is opposite to the 30 degree angle, so I will use sine of 30 is a half. That means that F1y is 50 newtons. Both of these are positive. F1x is pointing to the right. That's the positive x direction. F1y is pointing up. That is the positive y direction. Okay. We also need to find F2x and F2y. F2x will be F2 times the cosine of 60. F2 is 50 newtons, the cosine of 60 is a half, so F2x is 25 newtons. F2y is F2 2 times the sine of 60. The sine of 60 is 0.87. So that's 43.5, so that's about 43.5 newtons. Check the directions. F2x, the horizontal blue arrow, is pointing in the positive x direction, so it's positive. But F2y, the vertical blue arrow, is pointing down. That is the negative x direction, so it's actually negative. Okay. Now, finally, we need to find the total x component and the total y component. This is still, well, actually, no, this is step 5b, so I'll put it in a different spot for you. Okay, let's say step 5b. Okay, 5b is apply Newton's second law in the x and y directions. Now, Newton's second law is actually a vector equation. It says the sum of all of the forces is equal to the mass times the acceleration, but force and acceleration are both vectors. So, whenever you've got forces acting along more than one direction, like in the x and the y direction at the same time, then this is actually two separate equations. It's the sum of the forces in the x direction equals the mass times the acceleration in the x direction. And it's the sum of the forces in the y direction equals the mass times the acceleration in the y direction. So, sort of like in Chapter 3, how when we had a projectile motion problem, we resolved the motion into both its horizontal and vertical parts, and then we solved it separately as if it was two separate problems. You can do the same thing in this chapter with forces. You resolve all your forces into the x and y components, and then you solve the x part of the problem and the y part of the problem more or less separately. So, we're still here with step 5b, applying Newton's second law in the x and y directions. So, now what you do, let's take the x direction first. All of the forces in your free body diagram that have an x component, that x component goes on the left side of this equation. So, we have F1x, which is 87 newtons, and F2x, which is 25 newtons. And we add them up. Okay. That's the left side of the equation. On the right side of the equation is the mass of the cart, 30 kilograms, times the acceleration of the cart in the x direction. That's one of the things we're looking for. Okay, we're about to run out of room. But so this gives us 87 plus 25. That would be 112. 112 newtons equals 30 kilograms times AX. All right, I'm going to have to erase the top of the screen so that we can continue. So if 112 newtons equals 30 kilograms times AX, then AX equals 112 newtons divided by 30 kilograms. So, that's 3.7 meters per second squared. Okay, that's the x component of the acceleration of the cart. How about the y component? Well, now we use this equation, Newton's second law in the y direction. Some of the forces in the y direction. So all the forces that are in your free body diagram, you put their y components all on the left side of this equation. So F1y is a positive 50 newtons. And F2y is a negative 43.5 newtons. Those are all of the forces that have a y component. So we're done with the left side of this equation down here. The right side is equal to the mass of the cart, 30 kilograms, times the acceleration of the cart in the y direction, a sub y. So you have 50 minus 43.5, which is 6.5 newtons, equals 30 times a y. So we'll divide both sides by 30, and you get that Ay is 6.5 divided by 30 on the calculator gives us 0.22, or to one significant figure, 0.2 meters per second squared. So we found the acceleration in the x direction and the acceleration in the y direction, but we were looking for the magnitude of the acceleration. So let's find the magnitude. We'll use the Pythagorean theorem. The magnitude is the square root of the x component squared plus the y component squared, using the Pythagorean theorem. So that is 3.7 squared plus 0.22 squared, and then you take the square root of that, you get about, well, 3.71. If this is 3.70, then this would be 3.71 meters per second squared. Okay, so if you want to find the direction, then let's see, we need to clear some more space. If you want to find the direction, then you need AX is 3.7 this way, AY is 0.2 that way. It's obviously going to be a very small angle. It would be the inverse tangent of opposite over adjacent, 0.2 over 3.7, inverse tangent gives us an angle of approximately 3 degrees. Okay. Well, that is one example problem. I will post some additional example problems in other lessons.